Hello everyone, good morning children. Today we are going to learn about a different chapter, that is a chapter number 5. It's completely about a MS photo editor concept. Okay, so far we learned what is a PowerPoint concept, what is a tux paint concept. From 5th chapter we are going to learn about a MS photo editor. Okay, in this chapter we are going to learn about a introduction part, toolbar, how to resize and crop our images, how to rotate our image, how to adjust our image quality, how to apply the special effects, and how to save a new image. Okay, first we are going to see the introduction part. What is a MS photo editor? So photo editor, by the name editor only we know that it is a editing tool. So we are going to do some editing in our phone. Editing tool. So editing means what are the things we can do? You can crop your image, you can rotate your image. If you feel that size of your image is large, you can resize. If you feel that the size of your image is very short, you can enlarge it. So that is the resizing concept. And you can change your contrast of your image, that is the colors also you can change, and you can apply the n number of varieties of effect. We have n number of varieties of effect. Based upon your interest you can apply the effect. Next, we know what is a MS photo editor. So it is a simple or a basic image editing tool. Now we are going to learn how to start our MS photo editor. Same procedure how we followed in a PowerPoint, same thing only, but slight changes are there. You need to click on start button, all program, Microsoft Office. Under Microsoft Office, you need to click a Microsoft Office tool. After Microsoft Office tools, you need to click a MS Photo Editor. I'm repeating, start button, all program, Microsoft Office tool, and MS Photo Editor. And next we are going to learn about a toolbar. We need some tools to do the changes, right? Yes, toolbar, it provides a quick way to manipulate your images. Okay, and we have some of the tools in our toolbar. First is a select, second zoom, third smudge, fourth sharpen, fifth balance, sixth transparent, and seventh rotate. Okay, repeating, select, zoom, smudge, sharpen, balance, transparent, and rotate. Okay, next we are going to learn about our tools and their uses. Okay, first the select tool, it is used to select a image. So if you want to crop or resize, we need to select, right? So that tool will be helping us to select the particular image. Next, that is the zoom. Zoom help us to closer, it gives a closer view of our image. Next is a smudge. We have in grade 3, we learned about pixels, right, in output devices chapter. So smudge, it help us to transfer and manipulate the image pixel. Each image have a certain pixel, so it help us to transfer and manipulate. Next is a sharpen. Sharpen help us to make the edges appear more defined. So the edges, it makes them dark for our edges. Next is a brightness. So it helps us to adjust the brightness. So in phone also we have brightness option. If we feel that we want to increase the brightness in the phone, you can increase. If you feel the brightness are more, you can reduce, right? So same thing, we have a brightness option in photo editor also. Next is a balance, to provide a remarkable flexibility. So it helps us to provide a remarkable flexibility. Next is a transparent. Transparent help us to, that is not a transparent, that is a rotating option. So this is a transparent and this is a rotate. So it help us to rotate our image in all direction, either a clockwise or anti-clockwise, rotate 90 degree or 180 degree. So based upon our interest, it help us to rotate our image. That tool uses is that one. So keep it in your mind, select, zoom, smudge, sharpen, brightness, transparent and rotate. Now we are going to learn how to open an existing image. To open an existing image, what is the step is? To open an existing image, click a file menu. We have a file menu. Under file menu, click a open. Select the file in the dialog box. So we have certain images in our laptop or a system, right? So those existing image you can open by using this steps. Once the dialog box is open, you just select the file and click a open. Next, resizing and cropping. How to resize and crop our image? In our phone, if you want to resize or crop, what we'll have? We have certain options, right? Editing option. Similar to that, we have in our photo editor concept. Click a file menu and click a resize. We need to enter the height and width. For example, if you want to increase the size, you, based upon your interest, increase the height and width from its original value. If you want to reduce the value from its original value. Okay. Enter the new width and height, and after entering the width and height, you can click OK. Here only you can enter the width and height children. Here only you want to enter. After entering, click OK. See, similar to this, the image will be changed. I'll show you some video how to change the resizing and cropping concept. Okay. Next, we are moving to a rotating an image. To rotate an image, same procedure. Instead of resize, you need to click a rotate. And after clicking that, you need to change the orientation, whether you want to rotate left or a right, or you want to rotate in a inward or a mirror, or a, in a, which direction you want to rotate, that option also you can click here. After choosing the certain option, you want to click a OK. Then only the particular part of the image will be rotated. Okay. Next, adjusting the image quality. You want to adjust the image quality. In adjusting the image quality, we have a three option. One is a brightness slider, contrast slider and gamma slider. When I'm showing that video, you can understand what is a brightness, contrast and gamma. Now I'll give you the definition of what is a brightness, gamma and contrast. Brightness, it helps us to increase or reduce the amount of white in all colors. So we have n number of colors, no? In that color, it will reduce only the white colors. Okay. And shades of a gray in the image on the selected. So it will help, it will shade the gray color over there. Okay. So help us to change the amount of white in color. Next is a contrast. So it helps us to increase or decrease the difference between the contrast color and the shades of a gray. Okay. Next, gamma slider. So it helps us to increase or decrease the contrast in the dark areas of the image. In the dark areas of the image. Next, we have the two options. Either we can change automatically, that is auto balance, or it is the balance. Auto balance means it automatically adjusts the brightness or the contrast level of an image. Next is a balance. It is manually adjust the brightness. Okay, manually means we can adjust by the help of user. Auto balance, click image menu and click auto balance. For a balance, click a image menu and click a balance. Okay. Next, how to apply a special effects? We have n number of special effects, whether we can negative or we can use a watercolor, watermark, or a chalk and charcoal, or an artist effect. Those changes we can apply here. For that, you need to select all or the particular part of an image. Then click a effects menu. Under effects menu, the list of effects will be displayed here. The list of effects will be displayed here. After selecting your effect, make some adjustment and click OK. So these are the steps to do a steps to apply a special effects. Okay. Next, how to save a new image. To save a new image, what we will do in a PowerPoint, we'll have a save icon in a quick access toolbar, and we have a save in a MS PowerPoint option, right? MS Office button. To save a file, click file menu. You want to click a file menu. Under that, we have a save as option. You click a save as and type the file name in the desired box where you want to type the file name. After typing the file name, you can click OK. After typing the file name, you can click OK to save your file. Now I'm going to show you some videos how to do a rotating resizing option. Now we are going to see about a resizing and rotating concept. You want to click a open and you need to select the image. Okay, and I'm adding one more image also for showing what is happening before and after doing the changes. Okay, see here, I have opened the image twice to explain before and after effect. Okay, click the image, click a crop to crop your image. Okay, and in the crop margin, you can increase or decrease the size. If you feel you want to reduce, you can reduce it. Okay, you can do the changes in left, top, right, there also. After doing changes, you can click a OK. See what is happening. Okay, now we are going to learn about a resizing concept. Okay, here also width and height you need to change. Either you can change it in the form of percentage or you can change it in the form of decimal values. After doing changes, you click OK. See what is happening. The image is resized. This is the original image. Okay. Now we are going to see the rotating icon option. See, there will be the rotating icon right in a toolbar. Based upon your interest, you can either a clockwise or anti-clockwise, you can change the rotation. And again, move back to the image menu. There also we have a rotate option. You can change. Parallelly, you can see what is happening in the after, before and after. If you choose any option, it will show you how the changes will going to reflect. Okay. After doing certain changes based on your interest, you should click a OK. After giving OK only, the certain changes will be applied over here. Okay, so this is the concept about rotating, cropping and resizing. Okay, I'll show you how to do the special effects. So currently we have two images. See here, this is brightness, contrast and gamma. I told no. So by adjusting, you can do the changes here. After adjusting, you should click a OK. Then only the particular effect will be applied to that image. Okay. See here, when I am adjusting, the image quality is keep on changing, right? See, this is the original effect. This is a duplicate. Or after applying the effects, the original duplicate of an original image. You can apply the negative effect also. You need to click OK. See what is happening before and after. This is a negative image. Okay. Again, go to the effects menu. Click a watercolor to see the watercolor. Okay. Adjust the values based upon your interest. See, this is our watercolor option. Okay. Next, we are going to see about a chalk and charcoal. Okay. Click that, do some changes and click apply. See, this is our chalk and charcoal image. Okay, that's all about this affecting concept, children. So now I'm going to name these tools. The first is a smudge, second is a sharpen, third is a brightness, fourth is a transparent. Okay, so that's all about this lesson number 5 explanation part. In case any doubt, see the video twice, then you will understand. In case any doubt, you can ask me in the interactive session. Now we'll move back to the textbook part. Open a page number 41. We are going to do our fill in the blank. First question. Dash is an image editing application. So MS Photo Editor, that is a Microsoft Photo Editor. Okay. To take a closer view of an image, dash tool is used. Closer view only, that is a zoom. Okay. The dash contains mainly menu bar, toolbar, the space to display the images, workspace. Okay. So this fill in the blanks can be asked from the highlights only. In case any doubt, you can refer the highlights above and you can write. The dash provides a quick way to manipulate your images. That is a toolbar. Okay. The image quality can be adjusted using the dash menu. So everything will be comes under the image menu only. Okay. Next, label the parts. The first one, view, file, edit, view, it's there, no? That is a menu bar, children. That is a menu bar. Second, B. So it contains a certain tools, right? That is a toolbar. Third is a workspace. Workspace. Okay, now I request everyone to take a page number 42, that is the next question. So already we know the names of the tools, right? You need to write here. I'll explain. First is a select, second is a zoom, third is a sharp smudge, fourth is a sharpen, fifth is a balance, sixth is a transparent. Okay, write it in the same order. If any doubt, you can refer your textbook for writing this answer. Next, we are moving to the choose the correct answer. Click the dash to open an image. We need to click a file menu. We need to click a file menu. Okay. Which tool helps to crop an image? The select tool helps us to crop an image. Third one. Artist effect can be applied to dash, both A and B. The slider used to increase the contrast in dark areas of the image, darken area means that is a gamma. Okay. To adjust the brightness and contrast level of image automatically means auto balance. Okay. Now we are moving to the next page, that is page number 43. Observe the original image. We have an original image here and we have edited images also here. We need to write the effects, what effect that is applied to that edited image. See, what is the first image? A child with the three dogs, right? So the edited image is only one dog, so that is cropped. That is, they have cropped the image. Next, that is a zoom. Third one, this is a artist effect. Okay. Artist effect. Okay. First is a crop. Second is a zoom. Third is a artist effect. So that's all about lesson number 5, children. In case any doubt, ask me in the interactive session. Classwork part will be coming through a OODO. You can refer the OODO and you can start writing. Today I'm going to end my session, children. In case any doubt, you ask me in the interactive session. Bye. Take care.